Take my hand, precious Lord. Oh, lead me home.
Zola Curry asks, are you Martin Luther King?
Yes.
Then everything stopped making sense. He heard her talking about children, Congress, a blood clot, aggravation. He also realized he was in serious pain. He looked down and saw a letter opener sticking out of his chest. Yet he remained totally calm, and that characteristic demeanor most certainly
saved his life.
He had a fever and he was rasping in his throat and he was depressed and tired. He really was sick.
I got there about 5 o'clock or so.
It was already raining. It was a downpour.
We figured Martin could legitimately take the rest he needed, desperately needed.
King was convinced that no one would show up.
We could hardly get in. It was packed.
The crowd had more than filled the church. Thousands of people came out and were standing all around the walls, and many outside couldn't get in and wouldn't leave, even sick. Dr. King couldn't disappoint this many people. He got up.
Can you use me, Father? Use me, Father. Use me.
Nobody thought about that being his final speech. I know I didn't. I think he did, though. I think he did.
It seemed as though he knew, that he knew something that we didn't know.
I'm on yours. Use me, use me, use me. Oh, use me. Tonight.
It was the speech of his life. It was the speech of his life.
We have an opportunity to make America a better nation. And I want to thank God once more for allowing me to be here with you.
The most famous lines, the ones we know and remember, were at the very end of the speech. Less remembered is a poignant section that came moments earlier.
He talked about the woman who stabbed him.
Kind letters came in. One of them I will never forget. Said simply, dear Dr. King.
He got a correspondence from a young girl.
She said, while it should not matter, I would like to mention that I'm a white girl. I read in the paper of your misfortune and of your suffering. And I read that if you had sneezed, you would have died.
And she said, I'm so glad you didn't sneeze.
I want to say tonight that I too am happy that I didn't sneeze, because if I had sneezed, all right, I wouldn't have been around here in 1960. When students all over the South started sitting in at lunch counters. And I knew that as they were sitting in, they were really standing up for the best in the American dream.
And Martin picked up on that and did a whole litany.
If I had sneezed, I wouldn't have had a chance to try to tell America about a dream that I had had. If I had sneezed.
We were all in tears. We knew something was coming.
Something happened. And he made that famous speech. He'd been to the mountaintop, and he'd seen the promised land.
You will get there. I may not get there. And I'm so certain that his may not was, I will not.
It really doesn't matter what happens now.
But this was more than just a simple sermon. This was a prophecy for the ages, a definition of humankind's potential. And he said, what we're doing here is going to have extended impact on humanity.